everyone, and welcome to Catch Me Twirling. Today, we are starting our new series, the Champion Series. And today, we got the IBTF World Silver Medalists for their division, Cassidy and Sarah Doherty.
Hello.
Hey, now you're on Camaro's baton tour, team. Are you guys now coaches or still athletes?
We've now transitioned to coaching, actually, this year. So that's kind of a new journey we're starting. It's exciting.
Yeah. So you went to IBTF this past year and won silver medal. When you were on the, well, no, let's start from the beginning. When you were in practice, what was your main mindset going into IBTF?
Didn't really have a set goal. Like, we didn't go out there to get an end result, more or less. We just wanted to do our best.
We knew it was going to be our last like world championship, so we wanted to do our best and like make the most out of it. And no matter what we got, we really just wanted to do it together, you know. And we had lots of routines too. We competed in almost all the events, so it
Wow.
was a lot of practice, as you can imagine. But yeah, we just wanted to enjoy the moment, enjoy the trip, enjoy competing at the world, competing against all of our friends from around the world that we've seen multiple years. But yeah, going into it was a lot, definitely a lot of work. Yeah, a lot of hours of practice.
Now, would you say this world was different than any other world championships?
Definitely. It was definitely different because of all the different routines we could do. Like past world championships, it's like you can just do freestyle or you can just do individuals or anything like that. But this like combined everything, especially with the like WBTF and the MBTA aspect, like combining those two, which it was crazy because like I grew up doing both, right? And not a lot of people did that. So it was really cool to see it all come together. It was also extra long. Sarah and I competed in Gloria for Nations Cup. So we were there during the entire duration of the competition, both Nations Cup and the World Championships. So it's definitely a long time to be in the right mindset, competing, practicing, watching. So yeah.
I was watching the awards, and when I seen you guys, like when they called the UK people, I was like, oh my gosh, they're in the top two. And then watching your guys' reaction, I was like, oh my gosh, they're just excited and through the roof. Even
No.
they got in the top three. So
Yeah, I'm going in. We were
sixth
going
place,
in,
so we weren't like expecting anything like moving up that many
spots.
spots.
So every spot we moved up, we're like, no way.
Right.
We're like, oh my God, it's rotating. So yeah.
What was going through your guys' head during the award ceremony?
My mind was racing. I was like, oh my gosh, like I was so nervous. I was like, are they gonna call our name? Like,
I know.
or
And I was
what?
looking for like our coaches, Leanne and Kyla, because the audience was really big. It was a big arena. So I was trying to look for them in the audience just to see what they were doing, if whatnot. But I couldn't find them either. So I knew something was up, but I didn't know exactly what.
Nice. Now, you must have made mem can't speak mo g a bunch of memories at IBTF. Do you have any like particular memories that will stay with you forever?
Definitely just the friendships we've made with everybody across Canada. There was a wheel, for example, outside of the arena, and you could go, it was open pretty much the entire competition, and you could go in and ride the Ferris wheel. And you didn't have to ride it with, say, just your Camaro's teammates. You could ride it with anybody. So doesn't matter which organization you're in, where you're from, province-wise, we all kind of hung out together, which was nice.
And another thing was the opening and the closing ceremonies were probably like the best I've ever experienced. Like they had a light show and then they had like a concert in the closing ceremonies and like
Beach
beach balls
balls.
going up. It was crazy. And this is like dancing parties. It
Definitely
was
memorable
amazing.
for sure. Yeah.
Yes. Now, there's always like funny memories or like embarrassing memories. Have you made any like during IBTF or?
At the World Championships, embarrassing wise,
Well, I know when
Or like
it
funny
wasn't at
ones.
like this championships, but
I know when I was nine, in Switzerland at the Worlds, I dropped in my strut, right after Morgan did. So it was kind of embarrassing, obviously, because you can't really
Oh,
drop a
yeah.
strut. But it was funny now, like looking back at it, because it's like I did extra at IBTF now. It's like, well, to look back how far I've come, I actually did it. So.
Yeah, no, yeah, that probably would be an embarrassing moment for sure. Cassidy, I know your answer to this, but we'll ask it anyways.
Okay.
What's your favorite competition snack for both of you?
Mine's definitely cantaloupe. I have
Yep.
pretty much every competition. I don't know. I just always have it. I don't know if it's become superstitious for me or whatnot, but cantaloupe's always my go-to.
Could you get it in Liverpool?
Didn't I? Maybe. Yes, I think so. I'm pretty sure at least once. I want to say yes. Is either at the breakfast or I'm sure at the grocery store.
Oh, probably, yeah.
All the days kind of mix together when you're there for that long, but I'm pretty positive I had it. Mine is cucumbers and dip. I love cucumbers. They're my favorite. And I had to make sure because our mom came with us. I was like, Mom, you gotta get these at the store. Like, you gotta make sure you bring it back.
When you're in a different country and whatnot,
Country.
you never know what you're gonna find. Like
Yeah.
the closest grocery store, you know what I mean? But definitely, it worked out in our favor, so that was good.
Now, is there any piece of advice you would give to an athlete going to their first world championships? Because you guys are now world silver medalists. What would your advice be to that?
I definitely tell them that remember that you're twirling because you love it. And you're twirling because it's fun, and don't forget that little piece in you. It's like you're here because you love it. You're here because it's fun, but you also have that competitive aspect to it. So it's like don't take it for granted. Like, you know, try your best, put all the work, all the dedication that you have onto the floor, and you'll get the results that.
Yeah. I know world championships can be a very scary thing. A lot of people get very nervous, nerve-wracked when they're competing at the worlds, but you got to remember like everything you've trained for has led up to this moment. So it should be fun and exciting. And yeah, exactly what Sarah said, just leave it on the floor because that's all you really can do.
Yeah. Now you guys are coaching now. Will we eventually see you judge or something eventually?
Hopefully.
Hey.
Definitely working on it, but
yeah, we're looking into the courses that they run and stuff for us to get certified or anything like that. Like I just got my BTF's coaching certification done, so that's like the first step into everything. But
Yeah. Stay with coaching for a little bit first, and
Oh, for
then
sure. Yeah.
what happens.
Now you have some of your own athletes, right?
Yes.
Now did they see did they see you at IBTF competing?
I believe some of them watched the live
Yeah.
stream. I know a lot of our little kids are even now, we just did our Santa Claus parade and they're like, oh my goodness, you guys should go do your duet out in front. And it's like,
Yes,
that's what you remember too, is our duet is all everyone remembers their duet.
it was
But they're
a.
so young and they're still looking up to us like that, which is great.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Out of all your guys is because you guys have been competing for a long time together for duet. Out
Yeah.
of all your guys is like favorite duets at any like world championships, which one would it be?
I don't know. That's a hard question. See, we competed in Switzerland, for example. We were pretty young. It was kind of hard to remember. Like I was 11 and Sarah was
I was
nine.
nine.
So it's hard to remember exact, and we again competed in multiple events, so it's hard to remember exactly how each duet went over the years. I think this past World Championships definitely the most memorable because I'm obviously older, and I knew the stakes going into it. I understand how it felt. I'm pretty sure we both cried coming off the floor because we knew it was kind of our last performance together and whatnot. So I think the last one.
Yeah, I think definitely Italy is also one to remember because we did not expect anything out of that at all. Like, we were like, oh, we're just, you're doing duet because we love it. And then when we ended up making finals and then we ended up winning, it was like, whoa, like, what just happened? Right? But that was definitely one for the book.
For sure. I think we kind of touched on this going on to the competition floor. But when it is your last routine going on the floor and coming off of the floor, like, what kind of mindset should you have coming onto the floor and going off?
Yeah. I know it's hard when it's your last routine because obviously you want to try and do your best, but sometimes it doesn't happen, right? Fortunately for us, it all worked out. But we didn't really have anything to say. Like,
definitely going on, I didn't want to like psych myself out being like, oh, you have to do good. You have to do amazing. Like, this is it. Because I didn't want to, you know, like make myself
nervous
on top of my nerve already. So I was trying to just like stay cool, collective, you know.
Whatever happens.
And then when we finished, definitely coming off, it was excitement.
Emotion overload.
Like, yeah. I was like, oh my God, we're done. That was so good.
Yeah.
For sure. Well, that is all the questions I have for you guys today. Always thank you for guys coming on.
Thank you for having us.
No worries.